Welcome to Cegeka Podcast. I'm Mihai Popa. At Cegeka Podcast, we have short discussions with software engineers on technology topics. Today, we're talking to Alin Ciocan, who is an agile developer with Cegeka Romania, about his journey from a junior developer to becoming a senior engineer. Alin, welcome to our episode.
Hi, thank you. Thank you. I'm glad that I'm here with you.
So, to start, what made you want to become a software developer?
Well, I think it was when I was a child. I discovered video games and websites, and I thought that the internet could change the world, and I wanted to change the world. And creating a website was really easy. You just had to learn a bit of web technologies, and you were able to create your own website. And it was like an opportunity for me.
So, how old were you when you created your first website?
I think the very first website, I was like 10 or 11 years old. I was using an editor. I didn't know how to code, and it was an editor. It was called "What You See Is What You Get." So we were dragging and dropping buttons, images, text. It was really simplistic, but I was able to create my first website that had free music and free games. I don't think it was legal at the time, but I don't know.
Okay, all right. So from 10 years old onwards, how did you start out as a developer?
So I think I had this first website, and my classmates were really eager to find out more content and wanted more from me. And there was also some browser-based games. It was a game like, it was named Travian. So it was
actually, oh, I remember that. I remember that. Ah, so that was zillions of years ago. Yeah, I remember Travian.
Great, great. So the basic idea was that you had like a town, and you just attacked other towns, and other people attacked you. And it was really simplistic, just images and text. And I wanted to create my own game. But I was not able to do that with just what you see is what you get editor. Yeah. And I remember that I went to an older guy than me, with a couple of years older than me. And he gave me a book in Romanian. So it was HTML and CSS Learn. And that's when everything started. I started with some Romanian video tutorials. I didn't know English so well, so that's how I started.
Okay. And how long from then until you actually entered, let's say, commercial programming? And by commercial programming, I mean, being paid to be a developer.
I think the first time I was paid, it was from the father of a colleague of mine had the company, and what he wanted was a tool where he could ask some questions to some employees and then receive the answers, and that's all. So I think it was like I was like in the high school, and I was paid with, I don't know if I was would be to convert in dollars, like $10 for the app.
Okay.
It took me a weekend to develop that app.
What were you programming in?
It was really interesting. I was using PHP and Flash. Flash had a programming language very similar to JavaScript. It was called ActionScript. Unfortunately, Flash died.
Yeah.
I thought it was really cool to develop in Flash. It was really easy and reminded me of what you see is what you get. You had some controls that you could drag and drop, and then you had a button and said like, well, when I press this button, I want this piece of code to be executed.
Okay.
It was really, really nice.
So when did you first become employed as a developer?
Employed. So I had my first internship when I was in the second year of my college, but really paid the salary, it was in third year. So I was in my terminal year in college, and I started to work for a company, a corporation.
So that means you were what, 20, 21?
I think, 21. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And what was the biggest difference between coding on your own in your bedroom and going to work as a developer? What was the biggest difference and the biggest challenge?
I think the biggest challenge was working with people. I was not very good at soft skills, communication, neither English. So I had this communication barrier. Mm-hmm. And I also had a big ego. I wasn't very humble. And I had to learn that in order to achieve a great product, you need a team. You cannot work by yourself. You can just create, I don't know, simple apps as a single developer. Mm-hmm. But if you want to grow, also, if you want to grow, how much can you grow by yourself? You're not going to grow so much. You need people around you that have different backgrounds, different ideas, and that's how you're going to be able to be better. So I think working in a team, that was the biggest change for me.
Yep. Understood. So, what would you say, what does it take to become a senior developer from a junior? What would be the biggest difference? Where would you see the gap?
I think it depends from company. I've been working in four companies and they have different definitions. Most of the companies that I know, they think of a senior developer, someone who has technical experience, is someone that is capable of creating a product from start to finish with a team. It's more like a team leader. That's how they perceive a senior developer.
Right.
It's an experienced one. But what I see from a senior developer is also someone who is capable of communication, of understanding his teammates, of helping a junior developer, of going to a dinner with a client and, I know, creating a nice atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
It's a well-rounded developer, I think. It doesn't have to be like a really technical one, because, for example, I can tell you a story of a friend of mine. He was the Flash developer. He used Flash for more than 10 years. Mm-hmm. And he's older than me. And when Flash died, he needed to start with a new language. Okay. And he was not a junior developer. He didn't start as a junior developer because he was able to use his mindset and apply to a new technology.
Okay, so it doesn't really matter how long you've been exposed to a particular technology to become a senior developer, but rather it's a question of mindset and how you regard technology and how you use it.
Yeah. At least for my friend, it was like that, yeah. Because right. He had a family and he didn't start with a junior developer salary.
Okay. Understood. Yes. So for you, growing from a junior developer, which is obviously from your internship, what you joined as, did you have milestones that you've set for yourself? Okay, now I can be considered a mid-level developer, or did you have any specific points that you wanted to reach in your career so that you can say, right, now I'm a senior, or now I'm a mid-level? Did you go through any of those?
Yeah, at least at the beginning, I was like, I want to be a senior. So on average, you cannot be a senior if you don't have at least 5 years of experience. I mean, you can be earlier, but on average. So mm-hmm. I wanted to become a senior developer in 3 years. That was my goal. And I didn't think it was healthy. You should not set yourself a goal like, I want to become a senior developer in a specific amount of time. What you need to focus is, well, I want to improve my communication, okay? Mm-hmm. I want to be able to talk with the client. I want to increase my empathy. I want to become really good with this technology, this specific technology. So you need to set yourself goals that you can achieve and are not detrimental to your growth. Because mm-hmm. if you focus too much on this objective, that it's not healthy, you're going to miss out some things. Also, you're not going to enjoy your profession so much.
Okay.
Because mm-hmm. Being a software developer is not so much only about technical, but it's also about being a human. Understanding humans and using technology to solve their problems.
Okay. Understood.
Makes sense.
Yes, makes sense. It does. Okay. It does. So when you started out as a junior developer, were you working with the customer on a face-to-face basis, or were your customers, let's say, located in a different country?
So I started working in an outsourcing company, mm-hmm. and I think I had my first dinner with a client after a couple of weeks, but I was not talking with a client on a daily basis. I was talking with my teammates, and there was, let's say, a point of contact, a person who was talking with the customer.
Mm-hmm.
This was at the first company, but at the second company, I was, I needed to talk with the customer at least once per day. I mean, like, at least once per day, because the project was much more complex. We were like 30 team members. It was a huge team. Like, wow. We had an entire floor just for us. Yeah. And the product was so complex, and it was a legacy product, and you just didn't understand the business. So you had to talk with the, let's not say the client, but the client employees to understand what they want from you, because they didn't know either what they want exactly. They had an idea, and you had to work with them.
Okay. So was it easiest for you to discuss directly with the customer team, or was it easier to just relate to your team lead?
So it is easier to talk with the client employees, I think, because some information might be missing.
Yeah, lost in translation, as it were.
Yeah, I think. Yeah.
Okay.
All right. You get to be as close as you can to the source of truth, let's say, or the source of information.
Uh-huh. I got you. So when you think about someone who is looking to advance in their ranking as a mid-level or as a senior developer, of course, to advance their let's say their salary, what advice would you give them?
So if you want to get a higher salary, that's the question?
If you want to get a better salary as a better ranking developer, what advice would you give them?
It depends from company to company, but there are two ways. There are at least two ways. There's one that is artificially and it's very fast. And mm-hmm. there's the second one, which is organically and it's slower. So the first way is to switch the company. This is the easiest way to do
it. Okay.
So if you want a higher salary, well, you just find the company that...
job hop.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And it's going to work, at least in the beginning. For me, it worked. Each time I switched the company, I got a higher salary. But it's not going to be forever. You're not going to be able to do this forever. You're not going to sustain this lead. Also, we're going to have colleagues and not friends. For example, here in Cegeka, I can say I have my team members are actually my friends.
Mm-hmm.
I'm working for 3 years now. I'm not switching the companies anymore. Mm-hmm. But it depends if you are satisfied with your salary, your ranking, and you understand that for your growth, it's better to be able to see a software from start to end and not just small features.
Mm-hmm. So you're able to make a change, make a contribution.
Yeah, and that's the organic way. But if you are not satisfied with your salary, please go to some interviews, see if you can get a higher salary, and decide for yourself if you want to go artificially or organically. Mm-hmm. It depends from person to person.
So you've been with Cegeka for 3 years, you say?
Yeah. Huh? I'm working for Cegeka for 3 years. And that's interesting because in my first, let's say, 2 years and a half, I switched 4 companies.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, I got a better salary, but I wasn't satisfied with my job. I was feeling that I was just meeting new guys. And I was not able to make a connection with my colleagues.
Mm-hmm. So what do you feel changed when you joined Cegeka?
For me, it was also the project. I got really involved in the project. The project started in September, and I got here in Cegeka, I think it was in July. something like this. And I saw the client. I really empathize with his need. We are developing, political platform, and I really wanted to get involved. I want to change the world. I thought this product would change the world. And mm-hmm. we're still working on this.
That's nice. Yeah. Okay. It's a hush project, so we're not going to make the name of the customer public.
Yeah.
But I know who you're referring to, and it's a pretty interesting project. It's a political platform, still under the radar, but I guess people are going to hear about it in due time.
We're still thinking about features, and we have some people that are working really hard, a design team and everything, that is thinking how to solve this problem, because it's a hard problem, the political. And also, what was our problem was that a lot of politicians want to know that how secure is your platform? Mm-hmm. Because Facebook has some security issues, and how are you going to compete with Facebook that has an army of developers and security experts?
And what was the response?
So what we do is, I don't want to get...
into too many details, but on a high level.
Yeah, what we do is we are using best practice security. Mm-hmm. And we think the security is a process, not a state. So you cannot say like, we are secure. Okay. We are secure in this moment, but tomorrow you don't know.
Yeah.
Because there can always be a new security breach. So you have to be on watch for everything to be sure.
Understood.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, coming back to our initial topic. Did you ever feel like there are software engineers who, regardless of the time they've been in the business, regardless of the time they've spent as developers, never quite make it as seniors?
Yeah. And we had a case here in Cegeka. There were an interview with a guy who had 12 years of experience. He was a senior at that company. But our team leader couldn't hire him even for a mid-level.
Uh-huh.
Because what he did, he went to the senior level, but not by his technical expertise, by his soft skills, but just by the years. So there are some companies that promote based on years. Experience like that, but it's not organically. It's still an artificial growth.
Okay, so what would you say he was missing? What was he lacking?
So for example, he didn't invest in other technologies. He was using a CMS, a .NET CMS, and it's not used anymore. That CMS.
Mm-hmm.
So. He was not up to date with technologies because technology is changing each year. For example, when I was a junior developer, I wanted to learn a new framework. And by the time I learned that framework, a newer version appeared.
Okay.
It's a rapid changing industry. So you have to keep up with the technologies. And also you need to improve your communication, your English, your level of empathy. You need to be able to help others around you, not only to do coding, but grow other people around you.
Mm-hmm.
So my best advice for that guy would be to start improving himself. Choose a specific technology, a newer technology, and start learning. And also try to help others around him. Does it make sense?
It does. So, if you were to give someone an advice as to, okay, what is it that I might do to help me advance in my career as a developer? What would that be?
Salary or just ranking?
We're not talking salary here. Let's say you're happy with your salary. And that's not the point, but just to advance in your career, to become the best of what you can become.
Great. So if you want to do that, just ask yourself, how can you improve yourself? How can you improve the workflow of the project? Or how can you take more responsibilities? This is the best way, I think.
Okay. All right. Sounds good. Well, this has been Alin Ciocan, our colleague in Cegeka, Romania. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you also. It was nice talking with you.
Very good talking to you, Alin. This has been the Cegeka podcast. I'm Mihai Popa, and I will meet you again soon in our next episode of Cegeka podcast. All the best. Cheers.
Cheers.